this Herschel Science Centre short video tutorial, we shall demonstrate briefly how to do aperture photometry on SPAR maps. Aperture photometry measures the integrated flux density within a user-provided region. Usually this region is circular. The measured flux can be corrected for the background, which can be estimated from an annulus around the source, from another region in the image, circular, rectangular, or another shape, or it can be a user-provided value. Aperture photometry on astronomical images is a common task. There are a number of publicly available software applications to perform it. Most of them expect the input images to be in flux units per pixel, or per steradian. As an example, we are going to discuss the steps to perform in order to extract aperture photometry for a point source. We will start from the standard pipeline processed SPIRE point source calibrated maps. These maps are in units of Jansky per beam, so the first step is to convert them to Jansky per pixel. Once the images have the proper units, we can proceed to measure the integrated flux density within a given aperture. Next, the measured flux density has to be corrected for the actual source spectral energy distribution. By convention, the pipeline maps are calibrated for a source with power law spectrum with power law index of -1. The beam correction is needed to take into account the conversion from flux per beam to flux per pixel for the source spectrum. The aperture correction under point 4 is simply the correction for the missing flux outside the aperture, assuming a point source. And finally, the last correction is the colour correction for the actual spectral shape. All these corrections are explained in great detail in the SPIRE handbook and are tabulated for sources with power law or for black body spectral shape. Performing aperture photometry for extended sources is somewhat simpler. One can start directly from the extended source calibrated maps in units of megajansky per steradian and measure the integrated intensity within the selected aperture. For extended sources, neither the beam nor the aperture correction are applicable. Only the colour correction is necessary. This is tabulated in the SPIRE handbook. Note that the colour corrections are different for point and for extended sources. For extended sources, an aperture correction may still be needed, but the SPIRE beam-derived aperture corrections are not applicable for extended sources with an arbitrary spatial distribution. For sources much more extended than the beam, and for large apertures, the aperture correction should be close to 1. For the general case, the user has to convolve the known source brightness distribution with the SPAR beam and derive the correction for the selected aperture. In this tutorial, we are going to cover annular aperture photometry performed on maps converted to units of pixel per steradian. This is indicated by the blue shape on the flowchart for SPAR photometry. Another tutorial on SPAR photometer colour corrections will cover all the further steps required after measuring the flux in a user-provided aperture. These are indicated by the blue area on the flowchart. In the following example, we are going to perform aperture photometry on Gamma Draconis, the star used in the tutorial on point source photometry. The spire photometer observes simultaneously in three broad bands in the far infrared. These are centered on wavelengths of 250, 350, and 500 microns. The pipeline processing produces maps in each of the three bands, and each one has at least two versions, optimized for point sources and optimized for extended emission. The point source calibrated maps are in units of Jansky per beam, while the extended source calibrated maps are in units of megajansky per steradian. In the following example, we are going to use the point source calibrated map at 250 microns to measure the flux of Gamma Draconis. The first step is to convert from Jansky per beam to Jansky per pixel. One can do this by using the known beam solid angle and the pixel size of the 250 micron map. This can be done easily by using the Herschel Interactive Processing Environment, or HIPE, task called Convert Image Unit, as shown in this code snippet in blue. With the converted image, we can proceed with the aperture photometry. We are going to use the HIPE task called Annular Sky Aperture Photometry. However, the converted image can be exported to FITS and aperture photometry measured also in external tools. We use the recommended default aperture radius of 22 arc seconds for point sources on the 250 micron maps. The background will be estimated from the default annulus of 60 to 90 arc seconds from the source center. The task can be run via scripting, providing the sky or the pixel coordinates of the center. It can also be run interactively with mouse interactions. There are other input parameters for the task. They can be consulted in the HIPE reference guide. Once the task is executed successfully, the output, which is called result in this example, can be dragged and dropped from the variable panel on the 250 micron image to show the source aperture and the background annulus, as shown in the screenshot on this page. A few notes on the input parameters. The default parameters are optimized for point sources. The task accepts an input true or false parameter as to whether or not to derive a better centroid of the source within the aperture. This may have the side effect that the input center moves, which could lead to some undesirable results when performing matched photometry in different bands. In addition to the annular sky aperture photometry, HIPE provides two other methods for the background estimation: a user-provided fixed value and a user-selected rectangular region anywhere within the image. Which one to use depends on the particular case, but the three methods can be used and the results can be compared for consistency. Double-clicking on the results variable in the variables view will open the results panel. The input parameters table and the derived results table within the annulus are provided, together with some diagnostic plots of the curve of growth and the sky intensity. The total background subtracted flux density within the input aperture, as well as its error, are shown in the last line on the results table. Some useful quantities are also provided: the number of pixels within the aperture and within the background annulus, including fractional pixels if fractional input parameter is set to true. Note that the result product contains the measured integrated flux density in the aperture, corrected for the background. The next steps would be to correct for the fraction of the flux outside the aperture, and some other corrections which involve knowledge of the actual spectral shape of the source. These further steps are explained in the video tutorial on the color corrections. And this is the end of this video tutorial.